today is we're going to be trying out a new product. This came out not too long ago, and I really did want to try it, so I got this package in the mail yesterday, and I'm too excited to try it. This will be a first impressions. This will be a product review, and it is for Juvia's Palette. Let me at least put them in the middle of the ring light since they want to shine so bright. But this is what it looks like, and let me show you guys the amazing inside. Oh my god, this is so beautiful. So let me go on ahead and take that out so I can show you guys. This is the palette, and this is the lippies. I got two matte liquid lipsticks, and I cannot wait to show you guys. It's one is orange and one is black, and hey, it's festive. Okay, so on the back of the box, it says, a gathering of ritual celebrations filled with bold, daring, and mystic trances. A fetish party complemented by exuberant colors. The festival eyeshadow palette consists of 9 highly pigmented eyeshadows. Although you guys spell shadows wrong, I'm not gonna judge you, because it's not shadows, it's shadows with the A, not an O, okay? I'm not gonna judge you, but this palette is so bomb. This is really cute, and this is what it's hidden for. Well, this is what it's hidden for. Oh my god, I'm so excited. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use the color Oro, I don't know, it's like a gold, pretty golden yellow color, and I'm gonna use that as my base color, and I am going to go in and give myself some color. Let's see what the pigments is hidden for. I don't know, my kickback is looking a little extra. I don't know what kind of brush hair this is. Oh wait, the pigment is coming out. And it's so pretty. This looked like the color I am requesting Morphe to sell as a single from the Jaclyn Hill palette. This looked like that color. Oh my god. If it is, I'm gonna be excited. Okay, so I'm definitely in love. I wish this palette had a mirror so I wouldn't be happy to use every other palette's mirror. Okay, so since the base color is done, we're gonna go in with, let's see. Okay, so it's a little kickback, but not too much to really worry about. I'm trying to figure out if I want, ooh, look at those colors. Now it's pigment when it comes to my fingers, because I literally just, I tapped my finger on the palette. I didn't even swipe, I tapped. So that's really good. So maybe it was, well, it really was the brush. Excuse me, guys, I'm having a Nini moment. Okay, I'm gonna go in with Ofala. Ofala is right here. Please do not like be mad at me for saying these wrong. This is the M322 brush from Morphe. And we're gonna go back in that Ofala. See? It comes out more pigmented. So yeah, be aware of the brushes you use, because I would have probably sat here and stressed out the whole time. Okay, so Ofala, I like this color. And I like how it blends right in. Yum. Okay, so now that I have it just as good as I would like it, I am going to go in with Izafa. I don't know what that means. I mean, I don't know what that is, but it's the first color right here, and that's like a really pretty, I don't know, I want to say like orangey red, like a fire vibe. I don't know how to really explain it, but I'm gonna go in with that one. Ooh. That color looks so pretty. Ooh, I might be extra today, I don't know.
Let's take a look.
And so I'm gonna use that same brush because I'm just that bitch. They're definitely like the same color. I'm gonna see that. I don't really see that much of a difference. I mean, I see a little, but I feel like there could have been like a huge difference within color. But are you guys seeing this pigment? That's the exciting part about this video. Oh, and whenever you guys see, like, you see how it's not really blended? Whenever you guys see that, just go in with that first transition color, which was that yellow, and I just circle roundabout right at the edges. I'm liking this. Are you guys seeing that? How I smoked it down to the bottom? I'm fucking So we're gonna go back in with that first color, which is the lightest, which is Ofala, and then we're gonna go in with Azafa. Azafa? Oh my god. Okay, and then we're gonna do that outer corner with the darker shade of Azafa. Right, and then let me go back in with another brush and we can smoke that thing out. We leave no lines, okay? We don't like those harsh lines. Okay, since I believe that the powder has been on my face long enough, and I am done with the colors that can eventually, you know, stain my concealed areas, I'm gonna wipe those off now. Okay, so since I do not have a black in that palette, I am going to be using the Dare to Create palette, 39A from Morphe, and I'm gonna be using that that black color, and it's called Muse, and you can find it right at the bottom of your palette, right at the bottom. And I'm just going to be hitting that outer corner up because I really want to deepen it. But you gotta be careful. I like to dot in the places that I want to blend out. I'm gonna take another brush and I'm gonna blend that. Because I want that outer corner to be kind of smoked. When that black try to get messy, we don't got time. Oh, now I'm just like, I fucked it. So I'm gonna take the shade Kaleki, the dark color. Oh, I feel so bad. I am probably butchering the crap out of these things. And I wanna throw that on the outer corner. It looks pretty good. So the shimmer shades, they're pretty good on pigment. I like the way they're working themselves around. Ooh. I'm already feeling like her. She is me. I am her. Okay, so, oh God, I gotta have another moment. Come on, Nene. I said what I said. So the way that color is set up, the one that I want to use next, I really want to try and see how it looks with, oh, sorry, you guys. I just wanted to come back on camera even though I'm blending and show you guys that you do have to blend in order to get that look you want to go for. Okay, so I really want to use Odogwu, which is this gold color right here. That, oh my god, ooh. Well, I just stuck my finger into it while it was falling, and this is how much pigment was picked up. Is that good or no? My whole finger looks like a golden lolly. As this shadow is acting thirsty, we're gonna have to throw some Evian on there. Did y'all see that? Okay, let me stop. I guess the thirst was real, y'all. The thirst was real, y'all. Oh, yes. Come through. Okay. Let me find this. Okay, so let me go back in. You guys, I'm feeling it. I know y'all see it. I know. I did this for you guys. I did this in front of the camera so you guys could get that first impressions, that real first impressions. I think we're good. So I'm gonna get right back to you guys when I am done with this eye and I have some lashes on and I'm ready for the lip, okay? Y'all, so I don't know if I'm having a bit of an issue with my lashes, but these are Slayage from the Brag About a Lash Co. collection. And these are bomb. And we're gonna be using this Make a Revolution palette. Yes, I don't have a top to it. We're gonna use those two darkest colors because that's just what I like. And then we're gonna smile. Okay, so we're gonna use the True Complexions Contour Palette because I just absolutely miss this palette. I haven't used it since I got my Kat Von D, so I've been cheating on it. And I'm gonna mix the two darkest, the two colors. And I am going to go into my contoured areas. Okay, so you guys, this is the matte liquid lips, and this is what they look like in the package. And so with that being said, we have two colors, one orange, one black. They're called Doo-Doo and Soil. Okay, Doo-Doo and Soil. So I think because I'm not really a risk taker, or at least right now, I don't feel like I want to have like a black lip, I'm going to use the Soil, not the Doo-Doo. These feel good. Yeah. And this, whatever, it's like, it's not just like, oh, upright. It's kind of slanted. I'm liking it. First of all, this orange, I've never thought I would like an orange on me. First off, this is my first time wearing an orange for my lips. I feel like I need to go on ahead and go out. I need to hit up somebody's club. I'm feeling real saucy. Oh my god, I don't know what to do with myself. You guys, first of all, this matte lip, I put it on top of a creamy moisturizing lipstick, whatever you want to call it. I put it on top of that, and so that's probably another reason why it's not as drying, but I have not used it on my regular skin yet. I mean my lips yet, so maybe I'll try that next time. But this lip, this eyeshadow, I'm feeling it. Tell me what you guys feel. I mean, how y'all feel. I believe it cost me less than $30, $40. I'm not sure. I'll put the price right down there right now. Guys, this is a finishing look. I'm feeling, you know, I never thought I would be like an orange lipstick wearing type of girl, but I did want to try something new, and it's super comfortable on the lips. It doesn't give off that like, oh, this is super mattifying, this is gonna dry you out vibe. It gives the, oh, okay, it's just like a comfort matte. So it's a matte, but it's not too drying. It looks good, it feels good, I feel nice, it is what it is. But yeah, this video, don't hesitate to comment, like, or subscribe, okay? So I will be back soon. I'll see you guys in about 2 days.